Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Developer Advocate. And yes, this is Tom from MySpace on my shirt. And my gosh, who would have thought that in the year 2019, we would almost be looking back fondly at MySpace? I mean, like, sure, your computer might get infected by something thanks to a MySpace theme cross-site scripting vulnerability, but that almost seems quaint considering the current social media scandals. Like, doesn't it? Doesn't it? Anyway, I miss you, Tom. All right, enough of all of that. Let's get into this week's dev news. So first up, just a reminder that Microsoft Ignite, the tour, is currently taking place. And we're going to be in Tel Aviv, Milan, and Johannesburg in January. And I'm actually going to be at the Tel Aviv stop next week. So if you are there and you see me, please say hello. And Microsoft Ignite, the tour, will be taking place over the next couple of months around the world. And so information on all the technical content that's happening at each stop, as well as registration information, because this is free, is in a link in the show notes and the description down below. Next up, we've got a few things to mention regarding Azure DevOps. And so first, Microsoft MVP Mike Kaufman shows off a really cool project that his team created at a recent hackathon. And basically, they built an Alexa skill to work with Azure DevOps, specifically the boards feature. And so the idea would be you could say, Alexa, open Azure DevOps, and then navigate around the Azure DevOps boards. And so this could be really useful, you know, in like a stand-up or other instances where you might not want to have to fiddle with a keyboard and mouse. Right now, the implementation he has up is just a first attempt, and Mike is actively looking for feedback on what features people out there might want to see. I'm a big fan. And in other Azure DevOps news, there is now a security bug bounty for Azure DevOps in partnership with the Microsoft Security Response Center to our different suite of bounty programs. And so the bounty program will basically reward independent security researchers who find flaws and report them responsibly. And so the team will publicly recognize the researchers who report these security issues. And then for high severity bugs, we'll give them payments of up to $20,000. And so, you know, security matters. I think bug bounties are a great way for product teams and security researchers and tinkerers to work together, so that's really great. And links to the new bug bounty program and to Mike's Alexa skills post are in the description and the show notes down below. Next up, ML.NET 0.9 was released last week. And if you're not familiar, ML.NET is an open source and cross-platform machine learning framework built for .NET developers. And there are some big improvements in version 0.9, including GPU support for ONNX, a transform. There's a new Visual Studio ML.NET project templates preview, and there are some API improvements as well. And so links to the blog post and a getting started page are in the show notes and the description down below. In some Azure news, the latest monthly edition of the updates to the Microsoft Azure portal are now up on the official Azure blog. And this is a great overview of all the different changes that have come to the portal over the last month, including the big design refresh. And I know that I rely on this to keep up with what's new and improved. And speaking of keeping up with the latest stuff, I do want to give a plug to Azure Source, which is a weekly overview of everything happening on Azure. And it's one of my go-to resources for news for TWC9, and it's really worth checking out each week as a good rundown of what's new and happening. Also, just a heads up that the Azure Site Recovery team will be doing a Twitter AMA on Tuesday, January 22nd at 8:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. Pacific time to answer questions about Azure Site Recovery. And links to all this stuff are in the show notes. Over on Medium, my pal Jeremy Lickness has a wonderful blog post up about how to hack your career. And it's the first of a two-part series that really offers great advice and tips for career development for, you know, software developers and engineers. And over on the Azure Medium publication, we've got a few new posts this week. First, Matthias has a new entry in his Azure Cosmos DB and Functions Cookbook series, and this time it's focusing on shared throughput and new health logs. And Rob Connery has a really great post about how to create massively scalable WordPress websites using Azure. So links to all three of those Medium posts are linked in the show notes in the description. So over on Channel 9 this week, we have a ton of great video content. First up, over on Five Things, Burke is joined by Brian Holt, Beholt, to talk about magical ways that Visual Studio Code can work with Azure. And Holt and Burke are so fun together, so this is a really great video. And over on The Xamarin Show, James is joined by Mark Mercury to talk about the Azure Blockchain Development Kit for mobile apps. So that's really fun. And there's a crossover this week with the Open Source Show and Azure Friday, featuring people from both HashiCorp and Microsoft on both. There are people from HashiCorp, though, for both shows to talk about using Kubernetes and Azure, as well as everything you need to know about service meshes. And now it's time for my pick of the week. So, given my love of retro computing, you might expect that I've written in 6502 assembly code before. Nope, I haven't done it, but I've always wanted to. And thanks to Twitter, I might actually get a chance now. So AWSM on Twitter created a GitHub repo with a Visual Studio Code template that's designed to let people on Mac, Windows, and Linux write and compile 6502 assembly code. And it's really geared towards beginners. And like, I'm about to get on an airplane for 19 hours, and I think I found the project that I'm gonna nerd out with. So I'm super excited about this. Links to this awesome setup are in the description and the show notes down below. And that does it for me. My plan is that I will be recording next week's episode from my hotel in Tel Aviv, but if the episode is uploaded a little bit late, that's why, because if the internet isn't good, then I have to wait till I get back to the United States. Anyway, let me know your favorite retro computing projects in the comments or your thoughts on any of the stories this week. And if you like the video, go ahead and hit that like button on YouTube. And while you're there, subscribe to our channel, Microsoft Developer, for even more tech content. See you next week.